So the S24 series has a pretty decent battery life as far as phones go, but today I'm going to show you not only how to make your battery last longer every day, but also how to protect the lifespan of your battery without affecting the functionality of your phone, so make sure you hit subscribe now and we'll get right into it. So the very first thing that I recommend most people do is change the performance profile to extend the battery life, and this is a setting that by default prioritizes power usage, but for the day-to-day user, this isn't the best option. So to do this, all you've got to do is head into settings, scroll down to device care, and then in here, press performance profile. By default, you can see it's set to standard, but if you change this to light, it then prioritizes battery life and cooling efficiency over speed, which is going to make your battery last a lot longer. Now for day-to-day users, this is a must do, but if you're a heavy user like a hardcore mobile gamer, then it's probably not going to be a good idea. I haven't noticed any difference in performance when using the light profile day-to-day, but I ran a benchmark to test the difference, and you can see there is a small hit on the CPU performance, with 17% less for single core and 7% less for multi-core performance, but as I said, if you're not doing any intensive tasks, then you're not going to notice. Now we've also got a feature called auto optimization, and this is basically a set and forget feature, and it will make your phone automatically perform resets to keep your phone running smoothly, and you can choose restart when needed, which is going to restart your phone automatically when performance issues are detected, or what I prefer to do is restart on a schedule, and you can even set this as a daily task, but I just set mine to restart once a week on a Monday at 4 a.m. as I know I'll be asleep anyway, and it just helps keep things running well. Next, we can change the battery settings, and we can do that by pressing the battery in device care here, or you can go to settings and then battery. Now, of course, we've got the power saving mode for when you're desperate, and I'm sure most of you are aware of this feature and you can use it from the quick access menu. But if we press on power saving and then press on the three dots in the top right, we can enable adaptive power saving, and this will turn it on and off automatically based on your usage patterns. And then if we head back, we've got some customization on the power saving mode as well. But personally, I just leave them all enabled apart from limiting apps on the home screen. Everyone should also turn on battery protection, as this is going to adjust the charging behavior of your battery, and it stops it from overcharging unnecessarily. We've got three levels to choose from, which are basic, adaptive, and maximum. Now, basic is just going to stop charging your phone when it hits 100%, and it won't provide any more charge until it drops back down to 95%, and this alone is going to help the longevity of your battery capacity. Now, maximum is going to stop charging your battery when it hits 80%, and while this is the best for battery health, I can't imagine anyone wanting to use this, as no one wants to wake up with just 80% battery. But adaptive is going to be the best option for most people, and it uses the maximum setting while you're sleeping, and then it switches to basic just before you wake up, so this provides you with the best of both worlds. Now, the adaptive is, however, based on your usage patterns, so if you've got irregular sleeping patterns like working shift work, then this isn't going to be suitable. Another thing you can do as well, but this one is a bit extreme, but it may be useful for some people. If you head back and go into charging settings, you can actually disable fast charging entirely, and this is going to help the battery over the long term. But me personally, I like the convenience of fast charging, so this is something that I wouldn't change. Another obvious but useful setting here is the show battery percentage as well, and it's just useful to know because, for instance, if I'm out and about and I see I've only got 20% battery and I know I'm not going to be able to charge it for a while, that's when I'd open up the quick settings and enable the power saving mode. Another great battery saver is if we head into settings, display, and then scroll down to eye comfort shield. Now, I actually use this mainly because I'm terrible at sleeping, and it helps because I do look at the phone a lot in the evening. But the second advantage is reduced battery life, so I set this on a schedule to come on at 10 p.m. and then turn off at 7 a.m. So it's a great feature to save on battery as well if you want to use it, but understandably, a lot of people don't like the yellowness of the screen that it results in, but you can also customize the color temperature to your liking. Now, of course, there are more extreme power saving things like turning on Do Not Disturb, turning off Bluetooth, Wi-Fi, and data, but personally, I just don't see the point as it is taking away from the functionality of the phone, and my S24 Ultra lasts me the day anyway, so there's really no need. But these settings I've shown you are just going to keep the phone running as it should, as well as helping you keep more battery capacity over the phone's lifespan, and it's a great configuration for most day-to-day users. So hopefully I've helped you out at least in some ways today. So don't forget to subscribe to the channel for more tips and tricks with your phones in the future.